السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا مولانا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين، وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صلِّ وسلم وبارك على حبيبك ورسولك سيدنا محمد، صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا مولانا رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Alhamdulillah, my beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah, with Allah's barakah, we will continue the teaching, the book of Sayyidina al-Imam al-Rabbani Muhyiddin Abdul Qadir al-Jailani, Qaddasallahu sallahu al-Aziz, Sublime Revelation, Fath al-Rabbani. And we are now at still within the 38th discourse, page 244, second paragraph. We'll request Brother Ghazan to read for us tonight's chapter, inshallah. Fadal.
Knowledge is taken from the mouth of men, not from the pages of books. Among these men are the men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the piously devoted ones, the abstinent ones, the inheritors, the knowers, the practicing ones, the sincere. Apart from pious devotion,
I want you to read again the first line.
Knowledge is taken from the mouth of men, not from the pages of books.
One of the best and most important advices. So simple, but it's very important and meaningful. Knowledge cannot be taken from books. Have to be taken from al-ulama, the men. You mean rijal here? Al-men, al-ulama. No one became alim just because he reading books. He is a mischievous. If he made it today to reach the point, once, tomorrow he'll make 10 mistakes. Al-mujtahideen, al-mujtahid, mujtahid, the alim, who knows, he have the, in him, he has a, he's certified as alim. If he made a mistake, after ijtihad, because he search and go here, go through. If he made a mistake, not mistake, ijtihad, and he didn't reach to the actual answer, he still be rewarded. Hadith, Sayyidina Rasulullah, al-mujtahid idha asab falahu ajran, wa idha akhta falahu ajran wahid. Al-mujtahid, the one who smart, he's alim, he knows how to understand, how to read the words, the meaning of each words, and he to get from where his source of ilm. If he made a mistake, he has two ajars, two rewards. And if he made, if he made it with a correct answer and regarding the fatwa, he will have two rewards as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if not, he will have one reward, still be rewarded. The one who made, he has no ilm and he tried to answer questions concerning fiqh and fatwa. If he made a mistake, you know, he is the punish. And if he correct, he will be two punish against him. Now, one time he made it and later on, no. And we have now lots of qualities like that. If you are abid, if you do zikr, if you something and people get along with you, have majlis zikr, majlis, you know, okay. But if you see the people around you and you think that you are alim, put in your mind, in the eyes of Allah, you are jahil. How come you are alim? The crowd won't make you alim. Right? This is الفقه هذا يقول علم الآلة. The background. So very, I'm sorry to say that, very idiot people, wallahi. They make big mistakes and they talk something nonsense. So from where you got all these things? Ya akhi, you are worried about what? Are you concerned about people? Your concern have to be about the one who's watching you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's something which is very important. Therefore, the books never make people ulama. This is only information. You need books, information, not ilm. May Allah protect us. Naam.
Apart from pious devotion,
who are they?
There is only delusion and vanity. Sovereignty belongs to the piously devoted in this world and the hereafter.
No.
The foundation and the building belong to them in their world and the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love only those of his servants who are piously devoted, beneficent, and patient. If you had the right idea, you would know them, love them, and befriend them. One gets the right ideas only when the heart is illuminated by direct knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should not trust an idea that occurs to you until you really have that knowledge and the goodness and soundness of it are clearly apparent to you. Lower your eyes from the sight of forbidden things and restrain yourself from carnal desires. Accustom yourself to eating lawful food. Safeguard your inner by maintaining an awareness of Allah Almighty and your outer self by following the Sunnah.
Naam. Inner, the heart, muraqaba. Al-muraqaba, that means Allah is looking to that heart always. I have to keep this heart always clean. I will have biggest mujahada, struggle not to make any spiritual dirt enter my heart. Because this place for Allah only. Now when the king wants to visit you, if it happened they call you, say, the king is coming to visit you tomorrow. What are you going to do? You will make arrangement in the house, cleaning. You bring companies, you pay them how much they want. Please paint this wall, do this, clean that one, bring, and maybe you borrow carpets from somewhere else because, or furniture, and you, yani, subhanAllah. And then you invite people, and you, the best food, because the king is coming. Or maybe you'll spend for that moment, 1 hour, the king to visit you, the whole salary for 1 year. 1 year's salary. Because the king coming. Now the king of the kings is coming to your heart. How are you going to purify it? إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Pure heart. Pure heart of what? تَكَبُّر. نِفَاق. Huh? All the spiritual sicknesses. I can't imagine an alim who's supposed to cure the sicknesses of people who come to him to purify their hearts, and he has sickness himself. Cannot. Cannot. And then we can see in your life, the outer now, following Sunnah al-Habib al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have read about the Sunnah, and we know his humbleness, his how he made his hikmah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his ilm. The ilm is so, he's a source of all ulum. But the ilm here is how to talk with the people. How to talk with them, how to make the, and his patience, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. two patients, alayhi salatu salam. And you have another issue. As shaitan is sitting outside your heart, waiting to enter your heart. Shaitan, he wants to disturb what on you? Your clothes? He's not concerned about these things. Yeah, not concerned about, he concerned just about your heart. Because he's targeting what? The place where Allah wants to be pure. A shaitan and Rahman cannot be in one place. But Ar-Rahman, if you're sincere, he will support you to make sure that a shaitan won't have place in your heart. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Sayyidina Shaykh, you have ikhlas, ilm, al-arifin, al-warithin, inheritors. This is how he described those ahl al-taqwa, piety. And then after that, you will see the fruits. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose one of his servants because he is sincere, he will give him ilm and the ability to pass that ilm that you won't hear it in anyone else, from anyone else. You won't hear it from anyone else. And people will come to him and submit themselves to him because he's appointed by Allah on that place. And Sayyidina Shah Abdul Qadir Jilani himself, when he came to Baghdad, Baghdad was a city of ulama, city of knowledge. So he, when he came, he was nobody. No one knows who is he. They call him Al-A'jami. Al-A'jami, the foreigner, because he's not from that city. Later on, he entered at the age of 18. At the age of 50-something, he was Sheikh Baghdad. And now, in the world, when you say Baghdad, who will come to your mind? Sayyidina Shah. Now they call him Qutb Baghdad. But he was not from there. But he came, and you know what happened? Al-ulama. They have two ulama. Those whom they really love him, and they come to attend his majlis, and those maybe they have jealous or something. So they want, they go to him. The minute they go to him, that jealous straight away gone, and they become exchanged with, subhanAllah, Allah shall replace it with love. Why? Because they support in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You won't find anyone, no matter he's from which background, criticize Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir. No matter who belongs to what group. All of them muhibbin. And like Sayyidina Imam al-Ghazali as well, and other ulama. No one. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, he belongs to everyone. And he belongs to all. Not only for those whom the Al-Qadiriyya, let's say. And my message to all followers of Tariqah Qadiriyya especially, no matter who is your Sheikh, whether he is a direct descendant of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani himself, like Al-Faqir ilallah, no matter where he live, no matter from where he came, do not ever try to make differences between Al-Qadiriyya and other people, other Tariqahs. No. Because Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani belongs to all. He belongs to Chishti, he belongs to Rifa'iyya, he belongs to Naqshbandiyya, he belongs to Sahrawardiyya, he belongs to all, Shadhuliyya, all. And you won't find a single book by these people without praising him. You know, he's not in need for you to say he's... No, he's not in need. He's not in need. Who are you to do that? My advice to them, be careful of this. Don't talk about these issues, you know, anywhere. Otherwise, the big problem is what? Yawm al-Qiyamah, if you are a really Sheikh, Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you and bring front of you Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And then you have to answer if you create any fitna. When Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, for example, I heard someone talking once. He said, when Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani said, my feet on the top of the neck of Awliya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they said, Sayyidina Ahmed al-Rifa'i, Sayyidina Khawaja Mu'inuddin Chishti, they were raising to say, and my neck is the first one. They offer, I'm. See, that translated to, is not that mean he put his feet, no, he won't do that. Think he's the, he mean the feet, he's min ahlul tawadhu. Have you heard Sayyidina Rasulullah himself put his feet on the neck of anyone before? You heard this? No. This head, sujood to Allah, how come I put my feet on the top of that neck? This is false, you know, this is jahil, someone talk like that. The mean is daraja. And once any of them got the daraja, the level, the whole family will be happy for him. There is what I call tarahum wa talahum, not tazahum. Not sure whether they know this term, those people or not. Tarahum, mercy between their hearts. If those ulama, whom they are the purifier of heart, they don't have this quality, then who's going to have this quality? Can you tell me? The ikhlas and sincerity is something, and all of them there. And when Sayyidina Shaykh Abu Qajar talk about, when we read here, about he praising al-ulama in a way, subhanAllah. There is a names you have not heard. Nobody knows about. But when he talk about them, very high. He is Abdullah. He talk about Abdullah like him. And there's sometimes, I don't know from where these things came. I concern about what I read in his books and the genuine stories of his life. Malum, when he said something in his book, that's it. No one can say something else because he talked here about what? As he said, مُرَاقَبَةَ اللَّهِ يُرَاقِبِ الْقُلُوبِ وَاتِبَاعَكْ سُنَةِ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ. You want to see the Sharia on you. Other than that, no. And the same thing apply to all al-awliya wa salihin in this world. Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i said about Sayyidina Shaykh Abu Qajar, once one murid of Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i went to Baghdad, came back. So Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i said, you've been to Baghdad? He said, yes. Have you been to the Shaykh of Baghdad? And Shaykh Abu Qajar said, yes. He said, what you have seen there? Tell me. Oh, I'm like that, miracle like this. So Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i said, please tell me more, please. Al-Mazid, Zidni, I want to hear more. One of the murids of Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i, like Khalifa, he said, he had, like, book him, you know, said, who are sitting in front of, you know, who is this? Abu al-Alamein. Ahmad al-Rifa'i al-Kabir. He's not a, what do you call it? Normal. Yeah, so Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i, what he said, one of his sayings, he said, we've been offered the daraja of al-Qutbiyya when we are very young and we didn't care for it. Well, he wants to be what? Abdullah. He's no better than that. So when Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i saw that, the muridan, he said, leave him. He's talking about a man whom the sea of Sharia on his right hand and the sea of Haqiqa on his left. And Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani said the same about Sayyidina Ahmad al-Rifa'i. The sea of Sharia on his right and the sea of Haqiqa on his left. When you have your brother or any, you know, when he become famous, you would be happy for him. Sahih wa lala. They have more than that love. Because they are not nisbat, brother as nisbah, they are nisbah because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa. Allah described them like that. And Sayyidina al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he did the ukhuwa between the brotherhood between al-ansar and then between al-muhajirin wal-ansar, it was the best example you can ever imagine of brotherhood. By whom? By Sayyidina Rasulullah. That is the sunnah of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I hope that we will be within the same. You know, when I see any alim, mashallah, in Pakistan, in India, in Nigeria, in Argentina, who's following the same path, wallahi, I'll be very proud of him. And I will be happy if he allow me to study under him. نعم يا أخي العلم is Allah give علم to anyone صح ولا لا. And when Allah gives علم to someone, that means you have to go to that علم صح ولا لا. You don't be like nah. This is something which is that's our deen and that's the beauty of our deen. May Allah bless us with Rahman. أيوة تفضل.
Then you may receive a sound and correct idea and have true knowledge through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I educate only intellects.
This is very important also. He said now, what he did, listen to this carefully.
Yes. I educate only intellects and hearts. As for lower self, natural impulses and habits, no, they are not my business.
Again, please repeat this.
I educate only intellects and hearts. As for lower self, natural impulses and habits, no, they are not my business.
He said, my concern is يعقلون ويعلمون. عقل, this. أفلا يعقلون, mindfulness. He said, that's what I want them to understand. And القلوب, the hearts. He said, نفوس, this one I don't care. You know why? Because when you have a aql to think of, you know, properly in that aql, and you have a heart to feel, your nerves, other things will be under your control. Khalas, he said, then this will be changed. So I won't talk about them. Yani, if someone come to me, I won't say, why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? No, I will focus on something else, on him. When the doctor, someone will say, I have headache, or I have something, the doctor will say, okay, let me check. Or you have this and this because you have, for example, this organ is not working. You have fever. When you have the whole body fever, the fever is mean sign of sickness. Now we have to know where is the sickness. صح ولا لا. So you cure that sickness, the fever will go. So Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir said, your nerves, you have this, you have this one, that when you do this nonsense, that is the fever. Let me cure, I found, diagnose, where is the sickness, cure it, and the fever will go after that. No need to say, don't do this, don't do that. Lots of things. But go to the main engine, repair it, and the car will go fast. These are the qualities. Say, I'm not concerned, that's not my job. I know. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these people are so important. You know those people, like Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir and ulama al-akhirin, they are the one who, from under them, they graduated many other ulama. Imagine if that time no one graduated. What will be our situation now? But they go here, they go here, they're everywhere in the world, and they follow their guidance. On Hidna al-Sirat al-Mustaqim is a chain, one to other, another, one from one to other, yeah, like this. They are connected. They're connected. When we say a chain, a big sheikh is there, and this person is here. As long as he is within the chain, you can see Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani through that person. Because he's connected, he's doing exactly, and he's following. So that's what we need. Habib Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, accompany the one who remind you Allah always. When you sit with him, he does zikr, he asks you, give you example, he give you advices, he purifying for you your life and preparing you for better akhirah, inshallah. May Allah grant us always to be among them.
Oh, young men, you must acquire knowledge and practice sincerity.
One of the beautiful, when he say, oh, young man, you know, he's meaning, one of the beautiful meanings, in his majlis sitting many people, and sometimes maybe someone who's 90 years. But he say, no worries. Don't say, the train is left. You are very young still to learn. So mushkin nay, no problem. Ta'da masala. There's no issue. Sahih? So he, one of the beautiful things, how they, you have noticed, if you notice the way he talk, It's so nice, and I mean, in the way that make everyone feel happy and feel like, yes, I can do it, no problem. You can see young people, you can see, and alhamdulillah, that is Allah's barakah. Naam, tafadhal.
O young men, you must acquire knowledge and practice sincerity until you escape the net of hypocrisy and its bonds.
You need what again, Haji?
You must acquire knowledge and practice sincerity until you escape the net of hypocrisy and its bonds.
Naam, what does that mean? Sometimes people say, yeah, Sheikh, I don't know. I feel I'm a hypocrite. Why you feel you're a hypocrite? Sometimes I do this, then all of a sudden I do something wrong. Huh? Why I feel? You know, I want to be straightforward. Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qajir said, look, without ilm and sincerity, you won't get rid of this. You won't get rid of this. You will fall always because you're not protected. The virus already you have to have antivirus always, and antivirus that have to be upgraded always, updated. Always there's an update, you know, in the system, all the system, your computer, say there's a new upgrade. They have iOS, they have always, and I don't know this Android. always, why the things is changing and the new virus is coming. And there's always ulama will do research and to find solutions. So your nafs also same thing. You close one hole, it will open one hole for you. Unless you protected ilm and sincerity. Allah. He's talking about Allah's knowledge, al-muraqabah, purification of heart. This is the one who will help you. Once someone came to an alim, he said, my son, he's Allah trouble. He's like that. He have lots of issues. The alim said, okay, let him go and follow al-Junayd al-Baghdadi. Why? I mean, I'm talking about lots of issues. He said he has the medicine for him. When he sent him to Sayyidina al-Junayd, Sayyidina al-Junayd was his heart specialist. When he fixed his heart, the whole things disappeared. He said, I cannot. I teach him, قراءة القرآن. I teach him this one, Alif Bata. I teach him, but he needs first the engine to be fixed. Don't expect the car to run if the engine there's failure in the engine. And those people, straight away, you know what they do? Not repair, replace. Naam. Replace. You will see that person, different one. There are people in our life, they were evil. Later become like angel. When you check how that happened, they have accompanied, rightly guided people. And they became something different. We will talk about this. There is a chapter here, very important. We will reach to it, about how to find these people. This is very important. Inshallah, we'll reach to it. That will be very is very important for all of us. Inshallah. Tafadhal.
Seek knowledge for the sake of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala.
The most important here, sincerity, the knowledge for the sake of Allah. Naam.
Not for the sake of his creatures, and not for the sake of his lower world of his.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
The token of your seeking knowledge for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your fear and trembling at the advent of his command and prohibition. You must remain aware of him and be submissive to him, Allah, within your own self. You must behave humbly towards creatures, without needing them, and without coveting what they possess.
Naam, this is very, very important. Humbleness, ilm. Your knowledge will teach you how to be humble, and your knowledge not to be alim, so that you can get more or your pocket. There are sometimes, unfortunately, these qualities. I won't call those people as ulama or guide. I call them bankers or finance. Not for ilm. And you can see them very clearly. Ya Kareem, Ya Allah. And then, end of the day, how he going to stand in one day before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then he will ask him, have you been sincere? That day, the answer will be the right answer. He said, no, I was not. He will be the witness. So then what about these people? He won the charge not for himself. He will charge him because he misguided this huge amount of people. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. May Allah protect us and keep us safe. This is not a joke. Banatina fi dunya hasana. The hasana of dunya is a sincerity. Sayyidina Shah Muqajan said, Ashraful ibadat al-ikhlas. The most honorable worship is sincerity. Because it's needed in all your deeds, all your amal. Now,
it must be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you treat people as friends or as enemies. Mm-hmm. Because friendship for the sake of anything but Allah is enmity. Loyalty to any other cause is desertion. Giving to any other cause is deprivation.
Naam. So, these are, brothers, sisters, something which is, why we say, you can have money but still unsure if it is enough. Is there anyone you say have enough? Yeah, if you say you have enough, you don't mean you don't more. You say, of course, I want more. I mean, he's satisfied, but he's ready to take more. Not that mean sometimes people say, no money, not anything in this world. You say, okay, give it to me, and then you find that what is suits you. No, the money is something in this world, but one not necessary will bring happiness to you. So you can have money, but you're still unsure if it's enough. And you can buy food, but still unsure if you remain healthy. You can buy a house, but still unsure if you can make it a home. There is house, and there is home. The one is, he has a house, but there's a problem in the house. There is homeless here. But you can buy a bed, but still unsure if you can fall asleep or sleep well. And you see someone, he has a beautiful house, maybe the furniture. When you wake up, you say, I could not sleep the last night. Yeah, you have this bed, 5-star. Why? Because we put in ourselves, the bed will make us sleep well. When they saw a man in the desert, he is over 100 years, and he was looking of sheep, and he's a shepherd, very strong. They said, Ya Akhi, how you reach to that? He said, Taraktu al-hasad fa'abqa Allahu li al-jasad. I managed to let go in way from my heart, then Allah can keep for me my body safe. Al-jasad. Al-hasad is, So not necessary, But what they said, because you won't get all what you want if you are a millionaire or if you are healthy or if you have a house or you have a bed. The one who will give you all this is the one who have the world in his hand. The world all belongs to whom? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to reach to that, rightly guided people will Ar-Rahman, fas'al bihi khabira. The most merciful, therefore ask about him, the one who have knowledge of him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, as in Surah Al-Furqan. Once a man, the Shaykh was asking one of his students, he said, if you want to cross an area every day and there is a dog, what you do with that, the dog? He said, I try to run like this, I carry a stick, I do that, I come in a time when the dog is not there. He said, so you struggle? He said, yes, I will continue struggle. He said, oh, it's too long like that. So what should I do? He said, go to the owner of dog and tell him to keep the dog away from you. Wow, simple. The owner of the, if you want to pass the dunya, and dunya barking, you have to ask someone who knows how to keep the dunya away from you, from your heart, and keep it in your hand. Yeah, we have seen people, Allah, before, yani very stingy people. They can say, later on, they become too generous. No need to say, do this, no. Teach them the meaning of this dunya and akhirah and who control it. They will behave in the best way in this dunya and akhirah. Have you seen healthy people and complain always? Plenty of them. But there are some people, they are sick, but they never complain. Why they never complain? Because they know whatever. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعْلَمْ إِنَّمَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُلْ لِيُخْطِيَكَ. What's happened to you, you have to understand that it won't go, it came to the target. And what didn't come to you, it was not supposed to touch you. You lost the business today, you will get more business next year. Don't forget the moment you get the business and think always about the lose, the one you lost. Yani, someone who has properties, lots of properties, buildings. And then he saw someone, he don't want to talk with him. He was his friend. Why, he say, he sold his house to someone else, not to me. Ya Allah. Ya akhi, you have lots of, you talk about the house you lost and Allah gave you more houses. Why are you talking like that? Don't forget a ni'mah. I always said before, if you're going to complain about the ni'mah, the blessings, with no right, it might be taken away from you. Really, and then your complaint will be valuable. Yani, these are few things which we really, really have to think of it. In the end of the day, brothers and sisters, when you're talking about reaching to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ilm and sincerity and getting the knowledge of good, and we for Allah to change our life for better, we say writing in papers, not the same when you write in hearts. The people write in the pages, and there are people whom they write in the hearts. The pages, you will forget them, but what is written in your heart will remain in your heart. You won't forget them. Inshallah, the things written in your heart, all the good things, that Allah see them, when they see them in our hearts, he will be happy. The minute he is happy, you know, that means we have got the best for dunya and akhirah. Inshallah. May Allah grant us taqwa wal hidayah, as-salah wal falah, wal rashad wal rabah, al-deen wal dunya wal akhirah. Allahumma aslih ahwalana, wa aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina. Ij'alna min ibadika as-salihin, hudatan muhtadin. لا ضالين ولا مضلين وافتح علينا فتوح العارفين وارض عنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اهدنا بهداك ولا تولنا وليا سواك واجعلنا من سارع في رضاك. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. اللهم اكرمنا ولا تهنا، واغفر لنا وارحمنا وسامحنا وتب علينا. اللهم اكشف عنا واذهب عنا وادفع عنا وارفع عنا البلاء والوباء والعاهات والآفات والأمراض والأسقام الظاهر باطن وصافة ما ظهر ما بطن. ارحمنا اللهم فإنك بنا راحم، ولا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر. والطف بنا يا الله بلطائف لطيف لطفك الخفية، لطيفا بخلقه يا عليم بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه. طب بنا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيف لم يزل، الطب بنا فيما نزل، إنك لطيف لم تزل. طب بنا المسلمين وارض عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة في الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير.